My name is Robyn Heister, and I am a physician focused on genomics and translational medicine. I decided to focus my career on genetics for two reasons. I spent almost 20 years in the emergency room, and to me, it was evident that most emergency room visits don't result from a discrete injury or event. That's the culmination of events, decisions, experiences, exposures. So I realized if I wanted to make a bigger impact, I needed to figure out a way to intervene sooner. Rather than treating a symptom, such as a cough, or even a specific disease, such as cystic fibrosis, I can now offer targeted treatments based on a single change on the genetic code. You know, it's important to remember how new the field of genetics really is. We were only introduced to the concept of the double helix in the 50s. And it wasn't until about 50 years later that an international collaboration completed the mapping of the human genome. So that brings us up to about 2003, but it's really in the only maybe last 10 years that genomic sequencing has evolved from a research tool to a test available. The second reason I believe in the power of genetics is a personal one. I had my first child, Tyler, in 2004. In the first week of his life, I was told he had PKU.
PKU is basically a metabolic condition where I'm not able to break down the amino acid phenylalanine, so I have to keep track of all the protein that I eat in a day.
I was told I would be weighing and recording everything he ate every day of his life. So I bought a lot of scales. Because if he got too much protein, it causes brain damage. But if he didn't get enough, he doesn't grow. Those first few years, he could only have 7 grams of protein a day. So even a cupcake at a friend's birthday party was out of the question.
My earliest memory with PKU was probably when there was this birthday party and everyone was having cupcakes. And I wasn't able to have the cupcakes because the dairy and the wheat all have too much protein.
The reason Tyler's journey with PKU has been so influential on my career is that it blows me away when I think of all the progress that's been made, even just in his lifetime. There are so many new options for genetic conditions that didn't exist even a decade ago.
The new medicine I'm on, it's called Palynzeque, and simply put, it is a replacement for the enzyme that my body doesn't have, so it breaks down all of the amino acid and turns it into another amino acid for me that I can actually use.
The difference between the way I was trained 20 years ago in precision medicine today is the focus on being predictive, proactive, personalized. I think we're gonna find it's a lot cheaper and more effective to prevent rather than treat disease.
The new medicine I'm on will hopefully start working in the next 6 months, and so I will be able to eat normally. And after that, they're working on gene therapies, which will hopefully come sooner rather than later.
I have worked on the front lines of healthcare for over 20 years and seen firsthand, time and again, how innovation saves lives. And frankly, I feel really lucky to be in a position where I have the education and the experience to weave together the best of what healthcare has to offer. On a personal note, I feel indebted because of the work that's been done for Tyler. I would love to help connect someone else to their miracle.